Chaos. Take a peek in here. One of my favorite little houses, and he's got some cool little art in here that he put up. This is our only rental property. Early furnished. That's just a training pen. We're currently training goats right now so they can carry a little bit more in their pocket. Sitting there out here. This is Ethan's house. I think he's actually asleep on the floor in there, so. This is Chi-Chi's house. He hasn't painted it yet. And our taming area is back there. Come on, Simmy, get up here. Add space for anybody that wants to use it. We got free shop space too. Of course. Got like a little art pavilion going on in here. That are too big for the pet store. Buy them at the shop over stall over there. You'll see it in a minute. Keep them in here. And then we've got Mistress's pet store. He's currently running a sale on the goats. Come in, it's a nice little cozy pet store, and you can see them through the windows. Got info about them posted under the windows. That's our junk shed. That's where we keep all our junk. This is our workshop. You might notice how it doesn't look anything like a notice board. I have a spotlight here. This is where the mystery event that we're running till the 31st. This is where you need to go first. And you need to read that. And then you need to come over here and read those little post-its up there to get you rolling. And there's the unfortunate victim. And this is kind of where we anchor our ships up down here on this end. Just a shipyard out there. There's a little fishing spot. We got dinghies people can come over here and fish in. It's pretty good fishing over here, by the way. I don't know why, for some reason. I think because the climate is so miserable. The fish seem to love it. And our ad, which you will see, hopefully after the event, it'll get put back up. And this is our little shop, one of our little shop stalls. This is Hang Glider Bingo. This is the rules and the prizes posted right here. I actually had a blackout bingo turned in, but I gotta go confirm that later. And they'll win the win the big prize. And this is where you should leave us a note, either on this board or throw it in this box right here, which is accessible to anybody. And we will get it because the notes are checked every single day. There's a couple public outhouses if you feel the urge while you're here visiting. You've got a visitor sign. Underneath the visitor sign is a free book that tells our little backstory and what we're doing here and why. This is our doctor's little apothecary shop, and he's got his lab upstairs, which I will. He's asleep in his lab again, I bet. I can hear him snoring. This is his surgery, and then his residence is over there on that side, which he barely ever makes it over there. He always falls asleep in his lab, so. And then we've got Mr. Finley's house. This was Mr. Stid's place until he took over the lighthouse duties. So this is part of the mystery event. That's all I'm saying right now. And I'm going to be doing some remodeling up here when that's over. This is Eric and Berta's house. And this one is empty right now because it was Chi-Chi's temporary residence until she got her house out there by the tame area. I wanted like a whole park-like, you know, feel to things. There's also some festive lighting on the plateau if you're here at night and you're in the mood. And we have our coloring pages, you know, if you like to color. Kind of got a, they're not loading in because it's Atlas, but it'll take a minute. But it's kind of a Halloween theme going on over here with those. And we got the mermaid stage. Of course, she's not going to load in either because, you know, why not? It's Atlas. I hope I run into him. Stand here for a minute. There she is. Okay, yeah. So, there she is, and yeah, the doctor's stuff's there. This is a little meeting spot I've made for us that we've never had to use because everybody in the company's pretty much chill, and everybody knows what they need to be doing, and everybody just does it. This is a Paint to See art store. So, put some art up in here. There's a little book describing listings that won't fit in this building that I can do. I kind of wanted this to feel like a park, you know, like grass and trees and little benches to sit on. And there's another character from the street. This is our greenhouse and our kitchen. Cook says she liked pink and green, so we went with it. This is the Sanctum building. like a minute for all this art pieces to load in, but... Almost Atlas, come on, you can do it. Chugga 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 chugga. Yeah, that's up there is the platforms. Hang glide off of, it's the tallest point on the whole island. Pretty much glide anywhere around here from there. We're always getting birds in here. Because I want to leave the doors open, but that's alright. We currently do have a guest in the sanctum. Might help forget my tiger. I forgot. So how this works is, and it's explained right here on the visitor's desk, right? You need a room, you need a place to stay. Come in here. And you pick what room you want to stay in, right? And the key to that room is right there in this box. Everything in the room is unlocked and accessible. So once you have the key, you can put all your things in one of these containers or whatever. And you can go to sleep and you'll be safe in here because nothing can get to you. Shut the door. Voila! Nobody can get to your stuff either, so you're good to go. I guess I could say that the Admiral Suite is just a big room on top up here. So, kinda, it's all done in the same theme, so we could match the furniture and rugs would all kind of coordinate together, kind of thing, because you can't paint those stupid couches yet. Please God, somebody fix it where you can paint some couches. Anyway, we've had a guest keep the key to that room, and I told her she would be fine to leave stuff there in case she needed another break from her people's driving her crazy over there where she lives. Until we, if we ever had need of the room, and then I would move it into the workshop for mover stuff. So, that's what we do here. We help people have a chill moment when they need one. And we help them get started if they need that. That fella's been asleep for a few days up there, but we have a sloop ready to go for him when he does wake up. Fixed our ship count, etc., etc., so we can have an extra sloop. Sitting in that thing, but yeah. Oh, I'm too close to the door. Atlas thinks I'm trying to open the door from the cat's back. But yeah. The port. Nothing really special. I tried to make it look nice and lived in and humble. You know, like just normal people live here. You know. Anyway, I was gonna keep this short and sweet today. I may get back on the stream later. Like I said, I had to go figure out a way or hours that we can confirm this bingo and I can get them paid, and then I have to run around and reset all the numbers if they've actually got a bingo, which will be fun for me because I like gliding, so I'm not really good at it, but I think it's a lot of fun, so I do enjoy it. But yeah, this is just our little workshop that we've used, our little building corner, and then Eric's got his little shipwright table over there if you need something, and then we've got our little, you know, dressing tables and stuff, and bring food down here from the kitchen, so we ain't gotta bother Bert all the time. I got a little repair bench and a smithy, and just your bog standard workshop. So, got a little bit of sorting going on. You know, this and that. Got your basics in here, you know. So, I try to put mounts up every night. This one's in here because he's got all my building stuff on him and I haven't. Oh yeah, I just found this map too, by the way. High grade G7. I need to run around and pick up some maps later today too. Anyway, that's it. I mean, if you got a company and you guys are looking for something to do now that the seas are quieter, y'all be welcome to come over here and hang out with us or do some of the activities we've got. You know, we've got this little murder mystery thing going on that's pretty cool. You know, it is what it is, so. Anyway, thank y'all. Hope y'all had a good time this season, because I have. It's been kind of slow at times, but, you know. It is what it is. You know, there's a lot of really good games out right now, and a lot of things going on in the fall, and people just get real busy in the fall. So, anyway, I'll see y'all sometime.